When coin collector Brad Sanders realized he couldn't find a 5-cent piece from 1972, he wanted to know why.
I had about $100 in 5-cent pieces and I was missing that 1 year. Couldn't believe it, so I started doing my research and found out.
There was a low mintage in 72, so when Brad found one, it turned his hobby into a money spinner.
That one, depending on the condition, can go from anywhere between, say, $5 all the way up to $200.
Brad and his partner Christy buy, collect, sort and sell thousands of coins in their hunt to strike gold.
It kind of turns into a little competition where we're looking for that one particular one, that first one to find it. It's just that moment that, yeah, it's exciting.
Some to keep an eye out for include this $2 coin commemorating the Queen's coronation. It could fetch you $50, while this 2012 Remembrance Day coin has been known to sell for $200.
It's also worth checking for abnormalities. Coins with stamping errors like double rims or upside down queens can command a pretty penny.
Each coin is different, so if you find something weird on it, then, you know, it's always worth going, hey, does anybody else have this?
That's one of our pastimes, is going through coins and sorting through them and getting all excited when we're finding more than the other one.
The technical term is noodling.
If you have coins around, check your change jars.
You never know what you might find. Tim Hatfield, 7 News.